I left the USA in the dark of night. I became a refugee from my own country because I wasn't willing to submit to terrorism.
Now, most of us weren't around in Nazi Germany, but what we see here in America these days is these checkpoints where they just stop us at the border.
Oh, look, we have a military showing up here.
Good. Hey, the reason I stopped you today is because I saw this car was unmarked. Is this a registered unmarked vehicle for undercover work, or?
We stand for peace and liberty, but we will not back down, and we will not cower, and we will stand. We will take America back.
Keep the cameras rolling, guys.
We get through. Gavin, we got five other people right here, ready to kill us right now. We're not done yet. We're five other people ready to kill us right now.
Okay, I got this recording.
You're kind of getting rough with him there.
Yes, I'm hurt.
Escape from the hospital.
So you just threw him on the ground because he's a mental... Did you seriously just throw a disabled person on the ground? No.
It was a form of command.
Okay, so you're threatening my family with force then, is that what it is?
We're asking you to leave.
And you're going to use force against me if I don't leave?
No, I'm saying they are going to be arrested if y'all don't leave our time.
So you're...
Here's one question, I was polite.
Is there a law that says I can only ask one question and you're not polite? I want to know why you're giving the guy trouble.
And he's in the Grant County Jail?
Yes.
And is he charged with anything else other than obstruction?
We don't have to walk into the gas chamber.
I think a lot of people misunderstand. They say, well, you know, Gavin left over misdemeanor charges, or Gavin left over an interfering with an officer charge, but it was never about that. It was about not complying with abuse. The USA has become this fascist nation that parades around and we wave flags and we say how free we are, but we have no freedom in the USA. And I want the world to hear that message. The USA does not have freedom. You do what you're told, you get permit or permission for everything. And if you do not, you are fined and robbed. And if you don't pay the extortion fee, you are imprisoned. And if you try to defend your right to not be kidnapped, you are murdered. Okay. And so we have a justice system that backs that up. We have a legislative system that backs that up. And worst of all, we have enforcers in our police that universally will perpetrate those crimes on the populace. So for me, I saw these threads coming together. I saw police officers. I heard reports from people in towns 100 miles away where police officers would say, oh, that Gavin guy, yeah, he's probably going to commit a mass shooting and fly off the handle. They were setting up these seeds and planting these seeds that we see them use in people against people in our court system. And so what happens in the USA is you obey and you keep your head down. And we have a society that says, I'm going to keep my head down and I then can be left alone. I'm going to obey and therefore I can believe that I'm free. And if I see someone resisting, if I see something standing up, I'm just going to say those people are crazy. They should obey the law. They should respect the system. And I'm going to turn away and just keep walking and then I don't have to deal with it. But I wasn't raised that way. And so when I started standing up, it was just this cascade effect. If I saw more and more corruption and more bullying and more lies, and I realized searching the entire nation, trying to find officers who would honor their oath, judges who would defend the Constitution, they weren't there because you can't exist in the justice system in the USA and actually defend the rule of law if you're an official. You play the game or you're out. And so what we have left is not a justice system. We have a system where every trial is a kangaroo trial. And even people who may have committed real crimes never actually get due process. But more than that, we have a for-profit prison system that's filled with countless people who committed crimes that were never crimes in the first place, crimes for which there was no victim, right? They create these paper trails and these statutes and volumes of law, and they say, well, it's a crime because this, you know, you didn't have the right documentation, or you possessed the wrong thing, you had the wrong gun, you had the wrong plant, now you're going to prison for the rest of your life. Most of the people sitting in prison never even hurt anyone, and the government never even claimed that anyone was hurt. Then you have the people that the government says, we're going to lock away because they're domestic terrorists, right? Usually what that means is they're people like me who were speaking out against the corruption, peacefully doing so, the Jeff Winehouses, the Schaefer Cox. And so what the government is accusing those people of doing is what government, the crimes the government actually committed. And we see this all the time. We see these kangaroo trials where people are set up and charged with crimes, sometimes that have a victim, but most of the time that are just paper crimes, document crimes, crimes of he said, she said, I don't like how that guy made me feel. It's police saying I felt threatened. It's judges saying I felt threatened. And so we have these people from you know, Schaefer Cox to Jeff Winehouse. You have the natives, DAPL protesters, the Patriot protesters, like from the Bundy Ranch, you know, people like Leonard Peltier. And so they divide us into factions, but they're abusing us all in the same treasonous criminal kangaroo courts. And if I have a message for the world, wherever you are, it's that we don't have to submit to that. And that's something that I had to grapple with myself when I saw these patterns. It wasn't about these one charges. It was about a pattern of the government in my county, Prosecutor Dano, Prosecutor Fedorak, Officer Kennedy. Yes, they're being used today to railroad me, to lie in documents, to bring false charges into court. But this is bigger than that. This is about either silencing me by fear, putting me in a prison, or even killing me if necessary. And that is what it would have come to. And I've seen this time and time again with other people. And so I've been called names and a coward saying, oh, you're not a patriot, you ran away. And I've got news for the people that say this, and I want everybody to understand this and not be afraid. You don't have to walk into the gas chamber. Don't ever let someone tell you that your courage is defined by whether you submit to a bully. See, that's what the courts are asking us to do. You will do it our way, the court says. We will decide if we're going to force you at the point of a gun to unlock your phone so that we can root around for evidence. And more realistically, so they could plant evidence on my phone. This is what I was dealing with. That was one of the last straws, is trying to force me to give them information so they could create evidence for a crime that never existed. And I simply wasn't going to tolerate that. I saw this coming together. And people say, well, no, you should have fought it on their terms. You should go into their courtroom. You should fight it their way. You should expend all your fortune hiring lawyers. You should go into a system where you hope that you can prove yourself innocent so that you can avoid jail and prison and death, and then turn to yourself and say, look, the system works. I'm free because I'm not in prison. When the people who falsely accused you, when the cops and the prosecutors who lied, when they will never be held accountable for anything. That's not freedom, and we don't have to comply. Courage is not bowing down to the bully who's kicking you in the head. It's refusing to submit. It's standing up for your neighbor. It's standing up for justice. And we no longer have a justice system. And I want to warn anyone, I want the world to know, the USA does not have a justice system. It does not have due process. People are locked away in prison for life every single day with no real trial, with no real due process. And this is happening all the time. And so we have a system that says freedom, freedom, justice, liberty, safety, and we're pounded into our head with those messages. But the reality is our justice system, our for-profit prison system, we imprison more people than any country in the world. Our police enforcers are like Gestapo, and they kill and hospitalize and abuse and rob more people than any justice system on the planet. They have perfected terrorism in the name of safety. And it's really important to understand and not be intimidated by what people say who don't want to actually look over and stand up and admit it. They want to just keep their head down and keep walking. We have a nation that's acting in fear, and that's why people don't want to stand up. But I'm here to tell you, you don't have to submit to that. You don't have to live in fear. You can say no and walk away. You can go to places like Mexico that have much more freedom than the USA. Does it mean they're perfect? Does it mean there's not problems? No. But I'm here to tell you that we do not have to submit, nor should we submit to these terrorist officers and courts and kangaroo trials We don't need to do that. We don't need to walk into a gas chamber. That's not freedom. That's not liberty. That's not patriotism. We need to resist, and we can resist. We have a right to resist. We can do so with honor. We can do so with peace.